Thank you.
You're welcome.
Excuse me. Question. Is this animal safe?
It's not tested on animals, if that's what you mean.
Yeah, I get that. I'm asking if you can use it on animals.
I don't know.
Really helpful. Just, we can... You just package all that up right there. Hello?
Alexis. Hi, this is Mrs. Wasserstein, and I am calling with some some awful news. Apparently, my very defiant daughter has taken it upon herself to cancel her very own bat mitzvah.
Wait, what? Why? Why?
She has made up her mind and is adamant about wearing a dress that I feel is completely inappropriate for a young lady to wear on such a special occasion.
Well, and like, maybe if I talk to her, I can...
No, she won't listen to anybody. Oh.
Inappropriate, as in she thinks I have fat knees and she doesn't want to be embarrassed in front of all her friends.
That.
Okay, well then I guess I just have some calls to make and good luck to you and Sherry.
Yes, well that's why we're in therapy together. The best of luck to you as well.
Buddy.
Hey, Alexis. Is my dad expecting you or something?
No, I just was in the neighborhood and I needed some milk.
Okay. Well, he's in his office, so...
Okay, great, thanks.
Now I gotta get back to kicking some grand theft butt.
Awesome.
I've waited too long for us to be together again. What happened to the passion, our dreams, our love for each other?
I can't afford to get myself wrapped up again in all of your drama. Look, you know I'll always have a special place in my heart for you. But with everything that's happened, I can't take that risk.
But you promised! You said that if I could figure out a way to get rid of James, that our lives would change. And I did. I did what you asked of me. What more do you want from me?
Nothing! That's just it.
Are you really going to say no to me? Look at what I'm offering you.
Oh. Hey, you. I didn't know you were dropping by.
Yeah, I tried calling.
Yeah, my phone is in the charger. Yeah, we were just
You know running... what? I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go because I have to go. But it was nice meeting you.
I don't think we actually met. You are...
Leaving.
Ay, mi amor. You must have missed the cash for clunkers program. You could have traded that one in for some good pocket change.
Do not do that.
Do what? Tell the truth?
Hey, baby girl, you okay?
I don't know. I'm sorry I pulled you out of your meeting.
No worries. I already know the hidden truth behind the hidden tooth. And be perfectly honest, you saved me from having to drive Stan Krieger back to Jersey. So, talk to me, Lexi. What's got your feathers all ruffled up?
Bat mitzvah's off?
Oh, no. Oh, I'm so sorry, Lexi.
I honestly don't know what to do anymore, Dad.
What happened?
The Mrs. Wasserstein is set on torturing and controlling her daughter for the rest of her life.
Okay, then. What about Sherry?
She's not talking to anyone. I don't even know what I would say to her if I could.
Well, you could say that she's missing on a really big thing in life. It's really a big deal. And that there's nothing worse than regret. And you also could tell her, you have a mom. You understand her frustrations. You could tell that it's all going to work itself out in the end. It always does, Lexi. You know that, right? Now, sometimes you have to fight to get what you want. You want it?
I do.
Then go and get it. You've done it before. And remember, the fish family are not quitters. Now, we tend to come in last a lot, but we do not quit. Talk to Sherry. I really think this will be a good thing for the both of you.
You're probably right.
I am. And you know, it won't hurt for you to talk to your own mom, too. Tell her the truth about that.
Dad.
She deserves to know. Give her the benefit of the doubt, Lexi. You know, she does mean well. It just sometimes comes across in a lovingly brutal way, you know.
Is it even worth the risk?
Yeah, everything in life is worth the risk. It's just up to you to figure out if it's important enough for you to take it.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
I am.
Hey.
Good morning.
Where's Dad?
At the store. Oh, no. I know, mija. Liliana's about to seduce her husband's killer.
Ay, no me diga.
No, Mom, please not today, not today, please not today.
I wasn't going to say anything, but please just put my show back on. Ay, look at her. Que bella. She's perfect. I bet you she never goes out of the house without her makeup on.
She doesn't.
So your father tells me that the bar mitzvah has been canceled. What happened?
Sherry's mom wants her to get another dress, but Sherry refuses, so...
And that's it? It's just about a dress? So why doesn't Sherry just listen to what her mother asks and pick another dress?
I don't know. She's a preteen. They never listen to their mothers.
It's not just the preteens, mija.
Anyway, I thought maybe I'd go over there today and try to convince her to get the party back on, you know? I don't want her to miss her bat mitzvah. That'd suck.
I don't think it's your place to interfere with a mother and her child. As I have always said, no one knows what's in the chicken soup except the chicken and the chef.
The one thing I agree with you on, Mom.
Well, then let it be. Let those two figure out what their differences are before you stick your beak into their business.
Easier said than done, don't you think?
Nobody likes a sticky beak, Lexita. Let them worry about their problems, and you worry about yours.
Well, if that's the way you feel, then I've been meaning to talk to you about something.
Oh, no. Un momento, please.
Huh? You know what? That's no worry.
No. Oh, please, Lexita, mira. It's just that I have been waiting so long for this moment.
Tell me about it.
Okay, I'm sorry. Sit down. Talk to me. What is it you want to tell me?
Okay. All right. Okay. In going with your... Mom.
What?
In using your analogy with the soup to the chef... I was the chef, and Daniel was the big, fat, cheating chicken.
Lexita, you know you never speak ill of the dead. You know better than that.
Speak ill? I'm trying to tell you that he made himself out to be something that he wasn't. Smoke and mirrors, Mom. He cheated. He lied about everything, okay? Lied about her savings, he lied about his successful business. When he died, he left me with nothing. Absolutely nothing. $4 hair dye.
Regardless, you never talk about someone who cannot defend themselves.
Okay. See, I knew this was a bad idea. Somehow you would spin it around on me, but so much for the mother and daughter talk. I'm just hoping that Mrs. Westerstein isn't as close-minded as you, or else Shari is screwed for life.
It was a risk, but at least you tried.
Told you, Dad.